If you're planning to install a solar PV and battery storage system, then understanding the energy consumption of a property is essential to ensure that the system provides enough power at the right time and will justify the investment made by the customer. And in this Q&A video made in association with SunSync, we'll be looking at how we estimate the energy consumed by an installation and if the energy generated by the proposed PV array will be worth it. Just before we explain the answer to this question, please be aware that this video is one in a series that we've made on the subject of installing a solar system on a domestic installation. They can be viewed individually, or you can click the link in the description below to view them as part of a free online training package to help you with your CPD and receive a certificate to prove you've completed the course. So a good place to start is to ask the customer why they are wanting to install solar PV. This may seem self-explanatory, as the normal assumption is to save money on electricity bills, but with the cost of solar PV array and the associated equipment getting into the thousands of pounds, customers want to know how long it will take to see a return on that investment. So before we start ordering any equipment, we need to estimate what the installation can reasonably generate in a year and offset that with what the customer's annual consumption is. And the MCS have produced a great document called the MIS 3002, the Solar PV Standard. This document lays out a sensible approach we can take when planning a solar and storage system on an installation. If we look at section 4, pre-sale information, it states that we must provide an estimate of the total generation of the installation so our customer can determine themselves if it's worth it. The installation I will be estimating is a 4-bedroom property located in the East Midlands. A family of four with two children, with both parents working during the day whilst the kids are at school. And this will be the property we'll be referencing throughout this series of videos on installing a solar and storage system. So if we are going to get the information we need so the customer can determine if solar is the way forward, then we need to know how much electricity they are using. Statements and bills are a good place to start, as they show us what the customer has used over the year and what they have paid. We could calculate each appliance in turn, how much power it consumes, and put that kilowatt hour price against it. Then we could follow the customer around whilst they use their appliances as normal, then use that to get a rough estimate of the usage over a week and calculate that for a year, taking into account also that the customer will have holidays and use the power less when they are out and about. So it's quite difficult to get a good view of energy consumption this way. We can use energy monitors, but we need a year's worth of data, so leaving a monitor on for that amount of time might not be ideal, but that monitor might come in useful a little later on. But if your customer has one, a smart energy meter readout is the perfect solution, as it gives an accurate usage chart over the days in the year. And if your customer is signed up to it, it could send readings every 30 minutes. You can get a very accurate assessment of the energy consumption of the property with most smart meters. Let's take a look at this one. We can see by using the smart energy software, we can navigate to yearly, monthly, weekly, and even half hourly energy consumption. If we look at the usage over the year, we can see a decline in the warmer months because the customers may have gone on holiday for a couple of weeks, have less of the lights on, and will probably be using the barbecue a lot more if the weather permits. If we have a property that has electric space heating, we will find a similar trend. In fact, we will see a sharper decrease of energy usage in the warmer months because of this. Another consideration is how the property is occupied. Do we have members of the household home all day, or does everyone leave in the morning for work and school and come back in the evening? Well, as we can see from the graph here, there is a clear difference between the energy used by both properties. The household where they have someone in home all day uses more electricity in the day than the half a day property. No surprises, as the all day home will be using the washing machine, have tea in the slow cooker, or will be on the computer at home. But in the evening, when everyone gets home, we can see a sharper rise in energy usage in the half day house. And that's when everyone is getting home, the kettle's on, washing machine, oven, and showers. We call this sharp rise the peak energy, and it really matters. Let's see why. Imagine if for a short period you switched everything on in your house. The amount of power being used would rise like this. It could even get close to the maximum current permitted by the DNO service fuse. So let's say our property has an instantaneous peak of 20 kilowatts. That's with everything switched on, which is the peak load of the whole property. Now, wouldn't it be great to have a solar battery combo that can match that load? The truth is, we're not going to be able to combine a solar and battery combination to provide the power needed for the peak demand of the property. In fact, This is something we need to avoid, as the cost of the inverter needed for that load would be just too expensive. Not to mention, the inverter would probably fall under G99 or even perhaps G100, which can cause further complications in the install. So let's have a look at the average consumption of the property. We can see here that the customer has an annual consumption of 4,382 kilowatt hour. So over 365 days in the year, that gives us an average of 12 kilowatt hours per day. Now, I know we use more in the winter than in the summer, but we're wanting to gain an average for the day, so 12 kilowatt hour is okay for us to use. We can map out how electricity is used in a normal day, like with this line chart here, with power being used in the morning and then rising in the evening. The higher demand in the evening will be falling outside of the generation in the day of the solar panels, so would it be better to use some of those higher consumption appliances during the day? Well, yes. But there is some things we can do, and these are habitual changes that can be made by the customer. Things like washing clothes in the day, using the tumble dryer timer settings, and getting into the habit of showering at different times, like in the morning, just to spread out that consumption. All this will spread those loads out so we can benefit from solar panels generating electricity in the day, and then any surplus energy going to battery storage to be used later in the day. Now, remember that energy monitor from earlier? Well, I asked our customers to make that change over the next 2 weeks, and we were able to reduce their peak demand in the evening from 8 kilowatts to 6 kilowatts. And these were very simple and easy to achieve changes, like using the slow cooker and washing clothes in the day. It is important to mention that we are only looking at the consumption of the property. Even if we did have a solar array capable of meeting the consumption of the property, the inverter and battery combination used would still not be big enough. This will not be a system that is completely self-generating, and it's important that we say that. But what we can say is that a significant saving in electrical use will be achieved, and all that surplus energy being generated and not used in the day will go into charge the batteries. So let's remind ourselves of the numbers from our property. The installation has an annual consumption of 4,382 kilowatt hour. On average, the customer is using around 12 kilowatt hours a day. Having made some changes to their energy use, the customer has reduced their peak demand to 6 kilowatts. But if you want to find out what we're going to be doing with those numbers, then check out the video here or click the link in the description below to watch it as part of our free training package to help you with your CPD and receive a certificate as well. But until then, it's bye-bye for now.